Rev up your engines!
One, two, three, four!
It's time for ScottyKilmer.com. It used to be true that if you wanted more horsepower in an engine, you get worse gas mileage. And that if you wanted better gas mileage, you'd have less horsepower. But Ford engineers have changed this all with their new ecoboost system. So let's take a look under the hood and see how it works. But first, we'll take off this cover so we can see what's going on inside the engine. This is a gasoline direct injection system, and the first thing you're going to notice is this shiny metal part. That's the fuel pump that puts up over 2,000 pounds per square inch of pressure. Now, normal fuel injection systems have injectors that work at 40 to 60 pounds per square inch, but this baby needs over 2,000 pounds per square inch. So you'll notice that the lines coming out of this gasoline direct injection system are made out of steel. They can't make them out of plastic because they have to be really strong. Now, if you follow the line, you can't see where the injectors are because they're hidden inside the engine. They inject gas directly into the cylinders. Now, in a normal fuel injected car, the fuel injectors inject fuel into the intake manifold. As you can see, the fuel injectors bolt right onto the intake manifolds. So the fuel is sprayed from the injector into the intake manifold, and then it has to go through the valve to get into the cylinders. But with gasoline direct injection, the fuel injectors spray the fuel directly into the cylinders. It's more efficient and it helps the engine run cooler so compression ratios can be higher. Now, since they have so much pressure, they can't use these old-fashioned fuel injectors. They have to use piezoelectric fuel injectors that can stand the pressure and fire correctly. And in this Ford EcoBoost system, it has twin turbochargers, one for each side of the engine, to give even more horsepower. And that's important because the old oil-cooled turbochargers had to be idled for 5 minutes or so before you shut the engine down so they wouldn't be damaged. Water-cooled turbochargers don't need this at all. And the end result of all this engineering is that you can have a smaller engine and have more power plus up to 20% better gas mileage. Now, this might look like a mild-mannered crossover vehicle to you, but once you start it up, step on the gas, you'll realize that it takes off like a rocket. And that's something even Clyde Barrow would appreciate. So the next time you're thinking about power and gas mileage, think about gasoline direct injection. It could be the wave of the future. And remember, if you have any car questions, just visit ScottyKilmer.com.